Everybody's a dreamer, and everybody's a star, and everybody's in movies. It doesn't matter who you are. There are stars in every city, in every house, on every street. And if you walk down Hollywood Boulevard, their names are written in concrete.
This is John Fernay, the co-host of the Maryland Crabs, with a special crab cake edition for you today. The Annapolis Film Festival will be in Annapolis from March 22nd through March 25th with more than 80 feature films, documentaries, shorts, panels, parties, and much, much more. Tickets and passes, which, by the way, are the way to go, are on sale now at AnnapolisFilmFestival.com. So go get them now, and you won't regret it. That I can promise you. Over the next few episodes, or crab cakes, we will be speaking to producers, directors, and actors to bring you some insight about the films you will love at the 6th Annual Annapolis Film Festival. So, with that said, let's get right into it. And on the phone from Austin, Texas, we have Robin Berghaus. How are you today?
I'm doing well. How are you, John?
Good. And you are the director of a film that is premiering. It's the Mid-Atlantic premiere in Annapolis at the Annapolis Film Festival called Stumped.
That's correct.
Okay. This is probably one of the most unique stories in the film festival. A great storyline. It seems very, very compelling. From what I've read, it's certainly on my list of ones to see. I'm going to talk a little bit about it. It's about a filmmaker out of Boston who suffered a life-changing illness, bacterial infection, which ended up having his limbs amputated, right?
That's correct. Yeah, Will had a group A strep infection. He had no idea that he had an infection. It actually was, there was a pain in his leg that he thought was a muscle pull because he had been lifting heavy boxes. He was getting ready to move cross-country. He ended up leaving Boston, going to Montana for a new job. And the pain got really, it just felt really uncomfortable. And so he ended up going to the hospital, and it turned out to be this group A strep infection. And he was going through toxic shock syndrome. He ended up having to have his arms and his legs amputated. He had no idea that he was going through that.
Oh, my word. I mean, that's more than a life-changing type of a change. And I mean, he was a filmmaker in Boston. And this is the story about how he has overcome the setback that he has. He went into a career of comedy.
Yes. So during his rehab, the thing that really helped him get through it was his sense of humor and the support from his family and his partner, Angel. And I noticed that, you know, he has a really dark sense of humor, but that was a really positive way for him to get through these, to be able to cope with his losses and also to break the ice, to break down barriers. You know, it's really hard if you're a friend of someone who's just suffered this extreme disability to know what to say. But because Will has this great sense of humor, it really helped. It helped bring people together and it helped him to move on.
Oh, I'm sure. I know I've got some friends that have MS, and they've recently diagnosed, and it's like, oh my gosh, you know, what do you say? And I'm slowly learning that you don't treat it any differently. I mean, that's, you know, it's almost sad to say it's their cross to bear. You've got to do that. You've got to move on. And humor really does have a way of working itself into dealing with something like that. I know that there is a local comedian here outside of Annapolis that was disabled in one of the wars, and he has a guide dog with him, and he's now turned to comedy as well, and he does stand-up comedy with the guide dog, and he just makes a lot of fun about his situation, and that's how he deals with it. I think it's a really tremendous form of therapy.
Absolutely.
Ultimately, but he doesn't just stop there with comedy in Stumped.
No. So Will, I mean, and Will's hilarious. So that's one of the really strong parts of the film, and so many people love that, but the film does take a twist because Will finds out about this experimental surgery that could potentially help him reclaim his independence. Like, you know, having his arms amputated meant that he had to have a lot of help with, you know, eating, with using the toilet, with bathing, dressing. And so he finds out that there's a team in Boston at the Brigham and Women's Hospital that's performing arm transplants. And he, over time, is approved for this experimental procedure and decides to risk his life to undergo it. So the film takes the viewers through that experience as well for him to get arm transplants. And Will was only the third patient at the hospital to undergo the procedure. It's still fairly new. It's considered experimental.
All right. Now, without giving a spoiler out, and you don't have to answer this. Is it successful?
Yeah, it's successful. It's successful.
It's amazing what medical technology can do here. Now, was he from Boston originally?
Yes.
Or was that just where the surgery
Will
was?
From the, both. Will actually went to Boston University. He studied English and film. He has 2 degrees from BU, and he was also teaching there. And so he spent many years there, and after his amputations, went back to Boston for rehab because his partner and his family were out in Boston. And so he had no idea that the arm transplants would be a possibility for him. He really didn't. He thought it was a long shot, but he turned out to be, you know, an excellent candidate for it. And Boston is, you know, it's one of the most innovative and it's just one of the most innovative places for medicine. People look to the surgeons and the researchers from all over the world at the type of innovations that are coming out of that city. So it's a great place to be. And that hospital, the Brigham and Women's Hospital that performed the arm transplant, actually also performed the world's first successful organ transplant in the 50s. It was a kidney transplant between identical twins. And the team that... Yeah, so there's so much history just at that hospital, and they've been pioneering the field since the 50s. So it's an amazing team. It's an amazing place, and he was fortunate that his family was there, and he had the support there, and you know everything just kind of aligned for him to be able to take that chance and that opportunity. But it's a lot of work to go through because with the arm transplant, the surgeons, you know, have. Well, first of all, I should say it's like an internal organ transplant in that somebody has to pass away in order for Will to get the arms. And so he was on a waiting list. And when there was a match, he underwent the arm transplant, then the surgeons have to go in and they reconnect everything. So the bones, the tendons, the muscles, the nerves, the blood vessels, every little element they have to reconnect from the donor arm to Will's arm, and then over, and so that the blood flow circulates, and also so that his nerves and his arm will grow down into the donor arm, and that's what powers the donor's hands. So it's a process that takes a long time. The doctors say it takes about a millimeter a day for the nerves to grow, and so it can take years for that to happen.
When was the surgery?
It was in 2014, so it's been about 3.5 years, and he's doing great. You know, just a few months ago, he made scrambled eggs for the first time, and
so
he's feeding himself, and you know he's been able to take over, just gain a little bit more independence with his daily routine, so that he can do more on his own, and he's really happy. He does not regret it at all, but the downside is that he has to take immunosuppressant drugs for the rest of his life. And, you know, that can cause problems. So, you know, it can make him susceptible to infections and to cancers, diabetes, heart disease. So right. That's the next stage in this process that, you know, doctors and researchers have been working on for decades, but they're trying to figure out how to minimize immunosuppression, you know, to make these procedures safer for patients.
That's a phenomenal story. And I think that it had to be difficult for you. And certainly I would think that his sense of humor probably helped you. But as a director, really deal with this in a tactful situation. I mean, this is a disability. Certainly this is not the most common, but what we're seeing coming back from the different wars with different amputees and just any kind of a disability which affects somebody's mobility. Was it really difficult as you're producing, as you're, you know, making this movie to tactfully deal with that?
I think that when I was getting ready to first meet Will, like on the very first day, I was a little bit nervous. Like I said, I was thinking, like, what do you say to someone who has recently had both of their arms and both of their legs amputated? I didn't know how that experience was going to go, but he is just a person, you know, and smart and funny. And so that little fear that I might have had going into the situation was, you know, washed away when I met him. And so, you know, we got along really well. And I also just really loved his partner Angel and his family and his twin brother, Tom, and his care team. You know, everyone was just so positive and hardworking. So I felt like it was a great experience working on the project with Will and with everyone involved.
Yeah, I would say, I mean, he's probably the ideal candidate for obviously a film as well as the surgery and everything else. That's just unbelievable. Is the prognosis, I mean, is he going to be able to, at, you know, sometime down in the future after all the therapies are done, which probably never will be done, but, you know, do they anticipate him being able to walk again and pretty much be totally self-sufficient?
So Will has lower body leg prostheses, and he can use those to get around. But he mainly uses an electric wheelchair to get around. And it's because he's had some pain with prostheses, but he also had, unfortunately, the infection caused some deterioration in his bones. And so his doctors have asked him to take weight off of his hips for now. Okay. So I don't think leg transplants will be an option for Will. And, because of that, because of the problem with the hips, but also because of the immunosuppression. So with getting the arm transplants, he has to take these drugs. Getting leg transplants, you know, that's putting more foreign material essentially on, you know, attaching it to his body, and which could trigger an immune response. And if he had, you know, if his immune system rejected his legs, it, you know, would reject his arms too. So I don't think at this point he's willing to risk that. The other challenge is that, you know, with the arm transplants, right after he had the arm transplants, they didn't work. You know, it's like I said, the nerves have to travel into the donor arms to make them work, to make them function. And the same thing would have to happen after the leg transplants. And you can imagine how much longer that would take because of the nerves traveling a greater distance. So he's not really sure that he would want to spend that much more time in rehab. So there are a lot of factors that play in. I mean, but it is really fascinating. And to think about the potential of having human legs to walk on is certainly something that he's thought about. But I'm not sure that it will happen.
Well, I'll tell you, let me just shift gears a little bit and get away from Stumped, which is, as I said, one of the movies that is on my must-see list for the Annapolis Film Festival coming up. But according to Jimmy Kimmel, you're an 11%er in the Oscars when he was hosting it. He said that only 11% of the women or 11% of the movies are directed by women. And you are one of the 11%.
I'm a woman.
Yeah. Have you found any barriers as you in the industry? I mean, we've heard all the horrible Hollywood stories. We've heard, you know, gosh, we've heard all the government stories. We've heard, you know, the whole Me Too movement and everything else is just such a powerful overdue movement. And it's an underlying theme for the Annapolis Film Festival as well. But as a female director, have you found obstacles in getting where you are now? I mean, and you're primarily known for shorts. You've done, you know, hundreds of short films, and I believe this is your first feature.
Yes, that's correct. Well, you know, my background is mainly in education. So I spent about 6 years working for Boston University, creating content for their community, for their alumni magazine and for their news website. And then I also had a number of clients that hired me for freelance work. So I would say I've actually had a really positive experience throughout my career. And I don't think that I've been discriminated against based on my gender. So I've been really lucky. And part of that's probably because I was working in an educational environment where people were really open-minded and really supportive of diversity. And I think also, you know, there were certain times when the way that I approach films is, you know, in a really sensitive way. And I don't know that it's necessarily due to my gender, but, you know, that I would get hired for certain stories because of my approach. And so also, like, I've hired women to be on my teams and I've hired men to be on my teams. And I'm always just looking for people who are compassionate and are hardworking. You know, they're really good at what they do, but they're also good people. And so I've surrounded myself with people that I just are friends and are talented, but that I want to work with. And so I really haven't had any negative experiences like the ones that sadly we're hearing are so common.
Well, I would have to think that Stumped and the topic of that would be told a lot differently from a male perspective than it would be from a female perspective. I think intrinsically I don't know whether it's a sense of a greater sense of compassion or whatnot, but I think it would have been a totally different movie had it been a male director as opposed to a female director there.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, it's interesting. I mean, I think that each person, each filmmaker could take an idea and make a completely different story. So it would be interesting to see, you know, male or female, you know, other people taking on the same topic, what they would come up with. I'm sure just based on their interests and their approaches, for sure, it would be different.
That'd be an interesting study. If money was no object, give Robin Burgess, you know, some money to produce it, and give somebody else the money to produce it, and see what they both come up with on the same topic. That might be kind of interesting to see. How many festivals have you done?
About 24 festivals. So we've screened all around the United States. We're, you know, we've been screening abroad. We're getting ready to screen in Melbourne and London at the BFI. So we've just been taking it to very diverse communities. We've screened at some high schools and some universities. So it's been really successful, and it's been appealing to a wide range of audiences. And that's been so pleasing to us to see that people of different ages and backgrounds are loving the film for different reasons. If you're in Annapolis, if you're in the DC area and you go to the Annapolis Film Festival, you are going to see dozens of films, and the filmmakers will be there. And that is a really unique experience because you get to engage with people from all over the world about their work. And so it's something that you can't do just by going to the movie theater. So this film festival is a really great opportunity for the public to engage about these stories. So, you know, that's exciting for us to be able to, as independent filmmakers, we have these films that, you know, we've worked for years on in some circumstances. And so to be able to engage with the public about them is so special. And, you know, for the public to be able to learn about how to make films and to be able to ask these questions that they wouldn't be able to is really special. So, you know, we're really looking forward to the Annapolis Film Festival coming up.
Well, and after Stump shows, you're going to be taking questions from the audience, I assume, which is most happens.
Yes.
What types of questions do you like? Do you like the stupid stuff that I'm throwing at you, or what kind of stuff do you like the audience to throw at your way?
Oh, you know, I don't have any particular question that I prefer. I like when people are really engaged about the film and want to know more. A lot of times they're really interested in the science. They're really interested in Will's relationship with Angel. Of course, you know, so many people are touched by that and can relate to that, and also want to know how he's doing. Those are the most common questions that we get, but, you know, people can ask anything. And, you know, I'm always just so grateful when people like the film and are engaged and are excited about it.
Well, what are you doing after the film? Are you looking, I mean, obviously I think nobody makes a film to put it up on the closet in the bedroom and never see it again.
Oh yeah. So I'm working on distribution right now, and we're still on our festival run. So when a film launches, there is a theatrical release, and festivals are considered part of that. So, you know, we have a window period where we're out at festivals, and eventually we hope to get it out for education, to universities, to, on broadcast, and then eventually online. So, you know, if people want to follow us on Facebook and Twitter, we're always posting updates. So if they see it at the festival and they love it and they want to share that with their friends, you know, like us on Facebook and Twitter, follow us, and we'll get information as it comes up. We'll post that information.
Which everybody should do. And we will make sure that we include those links to both Facebook and Twitter and everywhere else that you can find out about Stumped the movie. Stumped is going to be premiering on Saturday, March 24th at 3 p.m., first at the Annapolis Elementary School, and then also on Sunday, March 25th at 12:30 p.m. over at Maryland Hall, which is the large venue that we have in town. And it's looks to be a fantastic movie. I haven't seen a trailer from it, or I haven't seen a copy of it yet, but the description and certainly the conversations I've had with director Robin Burgess here, it's definitely keeping that on the top of my list of movies that I need to see. Have you ever been to Annapolis before, Robin?
No, I have not. I've been to D.C. a couple of times, but I'm really looking forward to Annapolis, and I'll be there for the festival, participating in a lot of those events. But if I were to venture out, what would you recommend that I see? Or, you know, all of us filmmakers who are coming, and if we have some time to get out into the community, what do you recommend? What are some highlights?
I recommended this a couple times last year to a couple people, but getting too far out of town tends to be problematic from a time perspective. What I would suggest doing is getting onto the Naval Academy and taking a tour of the U.S. Naval Academy. And that's a self-guided walking tour. You can take one of the guided tours to do that. Still a bit too early to get out on the water, but we do have a Annapolis Maritime Museum, which is in the walking distance over in a little section of town called Eastport, which has some fantastic history on the Chesapeake Bay, what it means and everything else there. If you're into the culture and some historic, we've got the Banneker Douglas Museum, which is actually doing a special exhibit this year in the 200th anniversary of Frederick Douglass. And that's got a whole, you know, display. It's about a three-story building, but it's right off of Church Circle, which is sort of the center of town there. Got lots of great little restaurants that are all within walking distance of downtown. I know that the Film Fest keeps you guys pretty centrally located. That's a heavy walking town. Just get out and check it out.
Thank you. It sounds wonderful. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, we do. We've got a really cool little vibe. It's very casual. The Film Festival does throw some really good parties, so make sure you don't miss those. Those are fun. And, you know, hey, what the heck? They're paying for you to come out here. You take, you know, drink their booze, eat their food. Why not, right?
Exactly. Have fun.
Well, fantastic. Again, I'm going to say Stumped is going to be premiering for the Mid-Atlantic premiere on Saturday, March 24th at 3 p.m. at Annapolis Elementary. Again, Sunday, March 25th at 12:30 p.m. at Maryland Hall. And it is Stumped. It's the story of Will Lautzenheiser, whose limbs were amputated due to a bacterial infection, and he has a dual arm transplant. This is not a prosthesis. This is an arm transplant, which is an absolutely fascinating story. And on the phone with us is Robin Burgess, who is bringing that story to life for us. And she'll be here at the Annapolis Film Festival, which gets underway on March 22nd. Hey, Robin, I thank you very much for taking time out of your day. And I look forward to seeing Stumped and certainly meeting you when you get into Annapolis.
Thank you very much, John. Thank you for your support.
Man, I can't wait. I was a fan in year one, and my admiration of this event only grows more and more each year. Remember, get your passes now at AnnapolisFilmFestival.com. And again, this is John Fernay, the co-host of the Maryland Crabs podcast, and thank you for listening. Please take a moment and give us a rating wherever you get your podcasts. And as for the films, I'll see you at the Annapolis Film Festival. And remember, voices strong, minds open. Was a non-stop Hollywood movie show. Fantasy world of celluloid villains and heroes. Cause celluloid heroes never feel any pain. And celluloid heroes never really die. Everybody a dreamer, and everybody's a star, and everybody's in showbiz. It doesn't matter who you are, and for those who are successful, be always on your guard. Success walks hand in hand with failure along Hollywood.